Sarah Maguire, who was the founding director of the Poetry Translation Centre, got in touch with me and said, there's this wonderful poet from Iran, Azita Ghahreman, and I think that you would really like her work. So it was Sarah who brought us together, and I think she saw something in the way that Azita writes and perhaps the way that I write that she thought would work well together.
I felt a similarity in her poems that related to relation with the nature, the femininity, mother and family and the memories. I have described and talked, I have talked about the same issues in my poems.
I am younger in this photograph, younger than anything I've ever written, and I am the third missing person. Inside me, undercover, my words were taking shape.
در این عکس جوانترم جوانتر از تمام جمله های جعلی و سوم شخص غائب.
Iranian language is very different to English. The way that people express themselves, the way that we just conceptualize the world in Persian is very different. When you're trying to bring that into English, it's not just a case of words, it's also a case of meanings and cultures.
Elhum is a filmmaker and somebody who loves poetry. And I think Azita's a very visual writer, and I think perhaps I am too. So Elhum was the perfect bridge between us.
We began to pick some of the poems that we chose from the different books.
I could then talk to Elhum about what we felt would be a good representation of Azita's work.
Some of the poems that they have been translated in this book in Persian, they are very complicated. But in English, in this transformation, it's like a rebirth for them.
I still dream of my red bicycle on the green shores of summer, my unruly hair casting shadows on the water.
هنوز خواب می‌بینم دوچرخه قرمزم را بر ساحل سبز تابستان.
When a poem is translated from Persian to English, there something else also happened.
Translating it is giving it another face.
All of the sense coming back to you, sense of home.
I think the translations were wonderful.